from the stable of Biscon Communications, producers of the Bisiolatile Show, Nigeria's number one general interest magazine show, comes BOS International Magazine. With BOS International Magazine, you can now enjoy the best of two worlds with Biscon Communications, the emerging media conglomerate. BOS International Magazine keeps you constantly in touch with events on the social scene as they happen. Global news, politics, sports, special interviews, fashion and style, and essential tips about life and living. BOS International Magazine is a complete package of entertainment and education at your doorsteps. Ask your vendor for a copy today. We welcome distributors across the country.
The Super Eagles of Nigeria, who against all permutations by the bookmakers emerged the new champions of the African continent following their superlative performance at the just concluded 29th edition of the African Nations Cup competition, arrived at Nnamdi Azikiwe International Airport, Abuja, to a tumultuous welcome by very ecstatic football-loving Nigerians who had thronged the airport in their thousands hours before the Arik airline aircraft that conveyed the victorious heroes from South Africa touched down at the airport. The pilot of the Arik airline that conveyed the Super Eagles and one of Nigeria's most experienced pilots, Captain Chris Najomo, who displayed the green-white-green national flag, exuded a sense of pride and accomplishment to have enjoyed the singular privilege of being the one in the cockpit on the historic journey back to Nigeria of Africa's new soccer kings. First to alight from the Arik airline aircraft that conveyed the victorious Super Eagles was Dr. Rafiu Ladipo, President General of the Nigerian Football Supporters Club. The 51-year-old head coach of the Super Eagles of Nigeria, Stephen Keshi, led the gallant members of the Super Eagles team that made us proud in South Africa. Goalkeeper Vincent Enyama, who put up his best ever performance at any tournament in his entire football career, which appropriately catapulted him to the number one position in Africa. Emmanuel Emenike, who flaunted the golden boot he won as joint top goal scorer in the tournament. Strongman and pillar in the Super Eagles defense, Anderson Echejele, who opened scoring against Mali in our semi-final matchup with a mesmerizing header off a Victor Moses clinical pass. Kenneth Obabuna, Sunshine Football Club of Akure's captain, who pocketed Ivorian soccer pal Didier Drogba and effectively retired him from the African Nations Cup in that make or mar Nigeria's quarterfinal match with Ivory Coast. The crowd went wild on sighting Sunday Mba, the homeboy and a mercuric midfielder striker from Warri Wolves, whose two vital strikes, the winning goal against Ivory Coast and that very ingeniously executed goal against Burkina Faso in the African Nations Cup final, ultimately changed the fortunes of the Super Eagles of Nigeria, who left for the tournament unsung and unrecognized, but now have become the toast of all. As 31-year-old captain of the Super Eagles, Joseph Yobo, who has announced his retirement from appearing at the African Nations Cup after six outings, which he crowned with the Nations Cup, showed the golden trophy to the ecstatic crowd, was further charged as singing and dancing intensified. On hand to receive the new African Kings of Soccer were Minister of the FCT, Senator Bala Muhammad, the Minister of State for the FCT, Ms. Olajumoke Akinjide, Minister of Sports and Chairman, National Sports Commission, Malam Olaji Abdullahi, and the DG National Sports Commission, Dr. Patrick Ekeji, incidentally, a member of the Green Eagle squad that won the 1918 Nigeria's First Nations Cup. Members of the victorious Eagles fraternized with their friends, relatives, and loved ones who had come to welcome them. The security men had a hectic time controlling the crowd. The cameramen and photographers from the different media organizations had a field day taking vantage shots and having exclusive interviews with the Super Eagles players.
It's just overwhelming right now. It's overwhelming. It's been a long time. I've never seen this before. I'm glad that people turn out to welcome the team. It's a good feeling, really.
Thank God that, you know, I got it at my sixth attempt. You know, I'm very grateful to God. It feels great. You know, I can't really explain the feeling, but now I'm just happy just to celebrate with everyone.
The real celebration began as the all-conquering Super Eagles left the Nnamdi Azikiwe International Airport and headed for Abuja City Center, where an unprecedented crowd of Nigerians, school children, youths, as well as men and women, had lined the streets to give a hero's welcome to the gallant Super Eagles, whose vehicle had to go on a very slow pace as the players acknowledged cheers and applause from the airport road all the way to the National Stadium, Abuja, where what was supposed to have been an elaborate reception organized for them by the FCT could not hold because it was already late and may clash with a presidential reception that awaited them at the banquet hall of the Presidential Villa, Abuja. Indeed, the banquet hall of the Presidential Villa, Abuja was fully ready for the all-important event with dignitaries from all spheres of life, from all strata of the Nigerian society, waiting with high expectations for the event which had been planned even before the Super Eagles emerged the overall champions of the 29th edition of the African Nations Cup, which was dominated by the West Africa sub-region. The presidential reception for the Super Eagles began in earnest as President Goodluck Jonathan, his wife Dame Patience Jonathan, Vice President Namadi Sambo, Senate President David Mark, the Speaker of the Nigeria House of Representatives and other highly placed dignitaries arrived at the banquet hall of the Presidential Villa, Abuja. The first item on the park was the address by the Sports Minister and Chairman of the National Sports Commission, Malam Bolaji Abdullahi, who gave an overview of the various challenges and hurdles the sports ministry surmounted on the way to the victory Nigeria achieved against all expectations at the 2013 Nations Cup final. The Minister of Sports hinged the outcome of the result of AFCON to the indomitable never-say-die spirit of the typical Nigerian, demonstrated by the gallant Super Eagles that brought back the pride in us as a powerhouse in sports, particularly football, in Africa.
Winning this trophy is only a milestone for us and not the destination. Our job will not be done until we fulfill Your Excellency's vision for sports in Nigeria, which is to make us the default champion of Africa, not only in football, but also in all other sports, and make us one of the top sporting nations on earth. Your Excellency, I must say that within the short time that I have been sports minister, it is clear to me that the sporting sector is peculiarly complex. And what determines winning or losing are not just what happened on the field of play. This is why I must seize this moment, even as we celebrate, to once again appeal to all of us who are stakeholders within the sporting family to put all the years of rancor and acrimony behind us. And stop creating and seeing crises where none exist. By this victory, we have seen what unity of purpose could produce. It has shown that if we are united and determined, we can win for Nigeria all the time. Distinguished ladies and gentlemen, we thank all of you and God bless you.
The president of the Nigerian Football Federation, NFF, Alhaji Aminu Meigeri, who further elucidated on the path Nigeria took to victory and the plans to sustain the feat achieved by the Super Eagles against the backdrop of the Confederation Cup in June, of which Nigeria as champions of Africa will fly the continent's flag and the 2014 World Cup qualification. He went ahead to introduce the all-conquering Super Eagles and the technical crew one by one to the public, led by coach Stephen Keshi and captain Joseph Yobo.
Early I locked out the African Confederation in the biggest championship anywhere on the continent of Africa. Your Excellency, we would like to work hard to strengthen our region. Best through the blessing of Mighty Israel, the federal government remains the major source of funding the NFL. The African Confederation campaign has taken half of our allocation this year, meaning that we will find it difficult to successfully prosecute all our above-mentioned programs. Mr. President, and distinguished dignitaries, thank you all for your time.
The footballers, their coach, Minister of Sports, the President of the NFF, Vice President Namadi Sambo, Senate President David Mark, were engaged in a photo session with President Goodluck Jonathan and his wife. In President Goodluck Jonathan's remarks, he congratulated the new African Soccer Kings for doing Nigeria proud, describing the victory as the best gift for Nigerians as we look forward to 2014, when we will be marking 100 years of existence as one indivisible entity. He reminded the August gathering that the visions of the great leap of Nigeria in Africa in football should not be lost in us as a people. President Goodluck Jonathan said the victory is a celebration of the resilience and dogged spirit of the average Nigerian, urging that this victory, which has been achieved for our country by a collection of stars from all spheres of the country, should bring us more together as a nation. He then went ahead to make the much-anticipated pronouncements of largesse for the young lads from individuals, corporate, state government, and the federal government, which was applauded with deafening and rapturous applause as the announcement was being made.
I want to assure you and all Nigerians that their victory at the African Cup of Nations is a good indication that there is also a victory for us as we work hard to transform Nigeria. Our dear Super Eagles, the major lesson of your victory is that no matter the number of people who doubts you, never doubt yourself. Never give up in the midst of criticism that may be unfair. Believe in yourself. Redouble your efforts. Keep the flag flying. It's a matter of time for you to begin to enjoy the fruit of your labor.
It's my privilege to present our prestigious national honors to all of you. Head coach, Commander of Order of the Niger. Officers of the Order of the Niger. The Captain, Officer of the Order of the Niger. And the members, Member of the Order of the Niger. Congratulations, my fellow Nigerians. I can assure you that the best is yet to come.
Globalcom Chairman Dr. Mike Adenuga Jr. and Alhaji Aliko Dangote, Africa's richest man, gave the Super Eagles $1 million each. Stephen Keshi also pocketed $200,000 from Globalcom Chairman. Mr. Jim Ovia and Tony Elumilu, renowned bankers and philanthropists, also gave the boys $500,000. Indeed, the victorious Super Eagles and their handlers have in one fell swoop become richer in hundreds of millions. The gesture, although very bewildering, is capable of spurring Nigerians in other spheres to put up their very best when they are called upon to lift the country's image in whatever endeavor they find themselves. The icing on the cake was the conferment of national honors on the players and the technical crew. Stephen Keshi, the coach, got the CON National Award. His assistants, Daniel Amokachi, Ike Shorumu, Sylvanus Okpala, got the OON. National captain of the team, Joseph Yobo, was honored with the OON National Honors Award. The remaining players got the MON Award. The federal government gave the Super Eagles monetary reward of 5 million naira each, with the coach and the crew 10 million naira each. The Super Eagles also got the certificate for a plot of land each in the choice area of Abuja from the federal government as an enduring show of appreciation to them. Now is the time for our sports authorities and government to begin to work for the sustainable and replication of this great outing and the Confederation Cup in June and the 2014 World Cup qualifier. There is the need for the Sports Ministry, NFF and Stephen Keshi to work together to avoid the distractions which could hamper the delivery of first-class results in the days ahead.
From the stable of Biscon Communications, producers of the Bisiola Chile Show, Nigeria's number one general interest magazine show, comes BOS International Magazine. With BOS International Magazine, you can now enjoy the best of two worlds with Biscon Communications, the emerging media conglomerate. BOS International Magazine keeps you constantly in touch with events on the social scene as they happen. Global news, politics, sports, special interviews, fashion and style, and essential tips about life and living. BOS International Magazine is a complete package of entertainment and education at your doorsteps. Ask your vendor for a copy today. We welcome distributors across the country.